What's up? I am currently headed north to the Appalachian Trail. I'm meeting a buddy of mine, Lumberjack, and we're going to hike 70-something miles on the Appalachian Trail this week. So I'm driving in my Land Cruiser, and I'm going to try to reach Amalocoa Falls tonight and spend the night there in the parking lot in my rooftop tent. And then pay for parking and head north and catch up with Bob, pick him up, and then drive back and start our hike. But he shouldn't be in. It's probably 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So, yeah, I'm excited. This is the most miles I've ever done on the Appalachian Trail. It's weird that I'm doing the same section for the third time in a row. I did it in 2015, 2020, and then again in 2024. So we originally wanted to do the whole Smoky Mountains National Park, but due to weather, we had to postpone it a few days, and it looks like there's still gonna have some weather up there. In fact, we might get a little bit of weather tonight and tomorrow, so we'll see. But it is what it is. It's gonna be good to get out into the woods. It's gonna be good to get out hiking. And I can't wait. So here we go. Let's go. All right, I made it to Macon, Georgia, just before Atlanta, and I'm about 3.5 hours from I think it's Dick's Gap where I'm picking Bob up. So I'm gonna crash the night here. They did say that we can do overnight parking, so I'm gonna go set my rig up and make some dinner and have a little camp out in the parking lot in my rooftop tent. So that'll be fun. Oh, I'm tired, that was a long day, long drive. Land Cruiser held up well, it did good. Falling more in love with that vehicle every day. Yeah. Got the tent set up here in the Bass Pro Shops parking lot. This is where I'll be spending the night tonight. Got it all set up. Gonna get some dinner going here in a minute. I did ask inside and they said overnight parking is totally fine. So it feels good here. I feel safe. Yeah. I get up early in the morning. Man, I love this tent. That is so cool. Tonight's dinner is chili mac with beef. So I'm just waiting for the water to boil. All right, here we go. That's better. Yeah, chili mac with beef. And let's see what we got here. Is it boiling yet? Oh yeah. Okay. So what we're gonna do, turn this off. Whoops, not that way. That made me jump. Turn down. And take the lid off. And we got the giant mac and cheese here. And we're just gonna. Pour it in there. All right, seal it up. Nice and tight. Oh, these bugs are bad. They're already bad. Okay. Shake it up. And then you let it sit for a little bit. All right, bugs are bad. Turn the light off. Well, good morning. It is day 2 of my adventure. Last night I spent the night here in the rooftop tent in the Bass Pros shop here. They let us park overnight. So now I still got about 2 hours, maybe 3 hours to get to Dick's Gap. And at Dick's Gap's where I'm meeting Bob, and then we're gonna go hiking from there. But I may have one stop before then, but it's a surprise if I can make it happen. All right, let's go. So I decided to take a little quick pit stop at the Bigfoot Museum here in North Carolina. I am so excited. I cannot wait to check this place out. I am in heaven. This is gonna be amazing. Made it to Dick's Creek Gap. Gonna post up here for a bit. Bob's supposed to meet me here. And we're gonna drive from here to Amalocoa and start the hike. But we're just gonna chill here for a little bit, probably pack my gear, repack again. Try to enjoy peace and quiet, but these cars come flying through here and it's so loud, it's crazy. But all right, let me get a little trail magic. Someone left some fuel, stove, carrots, bananas, a muffin. You know what, I'm gonna take a banana. Oh, they're cold too. This is fresh. I'll take a banana. Here we go. So watch for bears, watch for snakes.
Come on, boss.
Let's go.
Let's do that.
I just got excited.
Yeah. Not a lot of parking.
There was 2 cars here when I pulled up. Mine and the green truck. So why don't you back up?
Yeah.
I'll pull out and you can have my spot.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Picked up Bob. We got to Amalocoa Visitor Center. And oh, there's Bob.
What's up?
And we're gonna get our bags. I think tonight we might stay at the shelter and then hike out in the morning. Or we might get a few miles in today. I don't know. We'll see. A little wet.
See if the weather breaks.
And it's 68. So. Feels good. Feels good. So we ended up weighing our bags. before water, mine came in at 28.8 pounds. That was saying about 33 pounds with water. Bob's came in at 31 and a half pounds. So we're trying to figure out how to cut back a little bit, but I think it's mainly due to food. So, and we can't cut back on food, but I think we just deal with it and eat a lot of food, make it lighter and lighter each day. That's like the plan, right? But right now it's raining, so we think we might shelter for the night and hike out in the morning. Still trying to figure out the plan. Going to the lodge and getting dinner and having a beer sounds good though. I don't know, we'll figure it out. All right, see the weigh in.
Is that with water and food?
And extra water on the bag from the rain. every ounce counts.
It is, well, with nope. One, I've got another water bottle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you under 30?
I think so. I hope so. Dear God.
Ooh. Oh.
20, no, come on. 30.02.
Two tenths of an ounce. What is it, Bob?
Hold on. I can
take off a carabiner.
I'll lose the first aid kit. I'll
take,
get rid of
the... Take off a carabiner.
Yeah, take off a carabiner.
There you go. And then you're under 30.
What else? I mean, most of this is food.
Yeah.
What is that?
What? This?
What's that?
Thermometer.
Come on.
Coach, tell us how to do it.
I will pair you down. You'll do be it. Cruising.
Do it.
You'll probably make it all the way to...
Yeah.
Set a speed record.
Nice.
29.48.
That's good.
Something.
A little wet. We went and hiked up to the falls, kind of. We saw the base of it, and then we said, no, we don't want to hike up there more than we have to. So I think tonight we're going to stay in the local shelter here and then hike out first thing in the morning. And hopefully the weather won't be too terrible, but I guess we'll see. All right, bye Landy. See you in a few days. Stay safe. Don't let anyone else drive you. All right, Bob, let's go to the shelter and pack it up for the night. All right, we're starting our day off. Day one on the Appalachian Trail. Well, I mean, technically last night we were in the shelter, but we're gonna head north. We're gonna go through the arches here and we're gonna begin the trail. So here we go. We are 0.001 miles into our hike. Kind of getting the feel of our backs and our packs.
And how out of shape we are.
How out of shape we are, and how old we are, and feeling everything, but I couldn't ask for a cooler hiking weather. It's like Lord of the Rings here. It's amazing. Campsite in there. How sandy was that? Cold?
Yeah,
it
feels good, man.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, that feels so good.
Yeah. We are about 5 miles in. We are 2 miles to the nearest water source, 2 miles to Springer Mountain, and I think an additional 2.5 miles to the shelter we're looking at staying at. So we're just taking a little snack break. We're feeling a bit peckish, and we're gonna keep going. It's beautiful, a little buggy, but beautiful. Taking a little lunch break. Today's menu is nut and almond butter, two street tacos, a beef stick, and a fruit strip, and probably about 300 bugs flying around. Oh, you can see them on the camera. Ugh, get off my hand. Bob, what do you have for lunch? Mm-hmm. You haven't gotten that far yet? That?
Correct. Some protein granola. Lots of water.
Yep. Yep. I'm gonna keep going. Dude, the summit of Springer Mountain. Look at this. And there's the first trail marker. You wanna sit down for a minute, Bob? We just got to the start of the AT. The southern terminus of the Appalachian Trail. Whoa, look at that view, Bob. So we just came upon this section and like all these trees completely knocked down. Massive trees just snapped. I'm trying to figure out the way around it. Do you see, like, maybe to the left?
I think we can go this way.
Yeah, totally blocked the trail here. It slows down the hike a bit. That's kind of cool, right? Those trail volunteers have their work cut out for them. Look at that. Just completely uprooted. That section was awesome, Bob.
Dude, that's crazy. Those are
huge. Those are massive pine trees.
And oaks.
I mean, oh, but you didn't geofence this time, did you?
Nah.
So I made mac and cheese. That's gonna be awesome. What are you making, Bob? What are you having tonight? Chicken noodle casserole from ProPack Mountain House. What is ProPack? Is more protein in it? With a red pepper?
Yeah, dude.
Bougie.
Pro.
We are at day two. Our actual hike. Bob is up here filtering some water. I'm standing by this beautiful stream, and it's about 7:45 in the morning, and it is a beautiful day. Well, we've got to put in about I think it's 13 miles to get to Gooch Shelter. We'll be staying there. So what a day. A little wet. But what are you gonna do? You just keep hiking, right? Just keep hiking. Okay, so I kind of stopped recording after this because we had an interesting night that night. That we did get to Gooch Gap Shelter, and we decided that after we got there, we were going to get off trail because Bob got some bad blisters and it just wasn't smart to keep going, and tear his feet up. But when we got to the shelter that night, we had a whole crazy adventure with, a schizophrenic guy that showed up. He ended up sleeping under the shelter about 2 feet from my head underneath me. Cussed up a storm and all that. We ended up documenting the whole thing and reporting it to the National Park Service, who reported it to the local police, and it was kind of a crazy night. So it kind of just took the steam out of recording, and we kind of went into like survival mode. Didn't sleep much that night. We got out of there safe. The other families that were with us got out of there safe, but it kind of just killed the steam. But we didn't end our trip. We ended up going to a local brewery, or at least a restaurant that had some local beers. We ended up going antique shopping. I found a really cool antique pipe. Yeah, there it is. Thanks, Bob. That thing's awesome. And we had quite the adventure. I ended up doing one more hike after that on the way back to Georgia. Way back through Georgia. And then we are already planning our next trip. So I say the trip was a success. I had a good time. Bob had a good time. We took a bunch of notes on what gear we wanted to swap out for next time. So yeah, it was a good trip. It was a good hike.
Oh, yeah. Ah, yeah. Dude, get some.
Go all the way in.
Oh, my blisters.
Go all the way in, Bob.
No.
So this is a cold soak made from a natural spring that's in this thing here. Yeah. So it pumps out, goes into this container, and soaks the feet.
Oh, my blisters. Oh, my blisters hurt. Yeah, I'm starting to get numb.
Is that feel good to go numb?
It does.
I'm going to hold on to you for support.
Just do it.
Just do it.
Direct proportion to the leg going down.
I'm not going all the way in.
No.
Boosh.
I bet it would feel good though.
Yeah.
There's two, Bob.
Hey, Blaze.
Check out this hostel.